Now let's talk about the jet which is striking the plate tangentially like this, and the plate is symmetrical. It's a curved plate, but it is symmetrical. Now let us say that the direction of the flow of the jet is making an angle theta with the horizontal direction. So this velocity v, which is the direction of, which is in the direction of flow of the jet, will have two components, v cos theta and v sin theta, in x and y direction. It flows over this curved plate and comes out with the exact same velocity as it was entering with, because we have assumed that there is no friction along the surface of the plate. So it comes out with velocity v. Again, it will have two components, v cos theta and v sin theta. Alright, so let's find out the direction or the force in the direction x and y. So you will have fx, which is equal to mass flow rate into v1x into or minus v2x. Now what is v1x? V1x is v cos theta, and v2x is minus v cos theta because it is in the opposite direction. Okay, so you will have rho a into v cos theta, minus minus will become plus, and you will have again v cos theta. So this becomes 2v cos theta. Okay, so you will have fx as 2 rho a v square cos theta. So this is the expression to calculate the fx. Okay, now fy, how can you find out fy? M dot into v1y minus v2y. Now v2y is how much? V2y is sin theta, and v1y is also sin theta, v sin theta, both in the same direction. So you will have rho a into v sin theta minus v sin theta. They can be strict, you know, cancelled. So your velocity or your force in the y direction is nothing but zero. Okay, so this is the expression for fx, and this is the expression for fy, which is zero, because this is a case of symmetrical blade. Now let's talk about a blade which is, or a curved plate which is unsymmetrical.